for years, and I've lost it again, but I keep finding it, and it's stained and bent. There's a little book called Collins Tree Identification Book. And that's not a pagan book, it's just a book of, like it says, tree identification. And it tells you what the leaves look like, what the bark looks like, what the twigs look like, what the fruit looks like. And it's always in my bag, and it's absolutely filthy and stained, and it's flicked through. And every now and again, I find it in a bunch. I spend it, stick it back in my bag, and flick through that. Come across a tree, don't know, find out about it. So, once you've made your arms, how do you use them? Very important to learn about trees. How do you use them? Well, there's basic ways, what we did earlier when we first came in, you all took an arrow on the bag. Okay? And now you can ask a question, take the one answer. This one card, and then that will be your answer. What Owen isn't the same as Jing, Tarot, the runes, it's not a fortune telling device. It's not a crystal ball, or even crystal balls or something like that, but it's not something that's going to tell you exactly what's going to happen in your future. No divination system is going to tell you your exact future. Divination will tell you the influences of the future, ideas of what could happen, what could come about, and why. The influences on you that you may think about to make things happen. So, like a tarot spread, it's very simple to have number one. There's the three weaver spread, and that's where you take three Owens from the bag, randomly place them down on your table or your cloth. The first one is for the influences on this. It's like past, present, and future, but not exactly. It's like influences on the past, influences on the future, and influences on what's going to be happening. But influences on past, present, and future. So you ask your question, is this job a good good move for me? Am I doing the right thing? And so the influences on that. Past, the influences that we are now, and the influences of that in the future, and you can work out the answer to the question. It's quite clear you need a question to ask, you can't just draw three of them. Because you don't ask a question, God's got to tell you something, you're not sure what they're telling you about, are you? Do you know what I mean? So, there is another way of doing it, which is very similar to that, but we're not doing this. Just the first one is the overall theme of your reading, and then you do your three, three part question in the future. Or you can do something, two other methods. You can either have three drawn out at random for the influences on the past, three for the influences on the now, and then three for the influences on the future. Or you could be completely random, just grab them out of your bag, handful, whatever you feel like, chuck them on your mat, table, floor, and then the ones that are nearest the left are the influences on the past. The ones that are near at the centre will be the influences on the now, and the ones that are nearest the right will be the influences on the future. That way you might get one influence on the future and six or seven in the past and maybe one on the now, it depends, but that's quite random. That's the if you don't like the past, present, future too rigid, that's quite a random way of doing it. And then you are truly the will of the gods. Whereas if you pick them out, you might be thinking that way, so the way it works. So, you've got plenty of time. Have you got any questions?
Yeah, just on the last way of picking them up and chucking down, going left to right. What happens if they land face up or face down? Is there
good point. When you talk about divination of the runes and things, there's talk about being reversed, isn't there? And to me, and there's several ways of dealing with it. You can either, if they're upside down, you can say it's reversed, and so it's got the opposite meaning to the main keywords. So if it's death and reversed, it might not be death itself. It might be somebody else. But to me, and I guess it's different to you, as long as you're consistent in the way you interpret it, it's really up to you. But to me, I don't worry whether they're upside down or not, because I think that in every reading, you're going to have the main influence and the reverse influence from the truth, which is always. So if you draw the you, it's got these influences on it, it doesn't matter if it's reversed or not. You've drawn the you and the influences of the you, not you, the you, are what's going to bring, what's going to be your question, If you're talking about a job, this is the job, the right job for me, you drew a you, doesn't matter if it's reversed, and that's grief, that's endings, that's death, so acceptance of change. It's not bad, that's a fortuitous thing. So I think you're thinking, is this the right job for me, and the future, what's it, death. Grief, endings, acceptance of change. I think that seems to me to be well. I'm going to be accepting the fact that this whole job is history, so that is a good move for me. going to move on, as long as I'm accepting I want to move on.
Do I want to move on?
Can I accept it? It's a good thing. Yes, but it's trepidation, fear, and facing the fears. I don't know, maybe it's reversed. If it's shown that there's a trepidation or fear, it could be your trepidation or fear, it could be somebody else's fear. You might have to have them to overcome somebody else with some other fear. I'm not sure that it matters to me whether they're reversed or not. I don't know that, I don't know how you feel about that.
Well, you use the runes. Yeah, these runes, I tend to, if I throw them down, I tend to take the ones that are face up as the message I'm getting, the ones that are face down, and just ignore. More. Yeah.
Yeah?
No.
Do you not think that if you've taken them randomly out of the bag and cast them, then you randomly picked up six runes, and if you just take the message from one of those, as somebody's guided your hand to pick up those other five?
Mm.
I guess that's what works for you, I suppose. If that's the way you do it, I think you need to do that every time you use them.
Yeah.
And I think you can pick and choose. So, well,